you don't set up your URL tracking parameters correctly, you won't be able to see the full picture when it comes to performance of your Google Ads traffic on your website. So first, let's take a look at what we mean by URL parameters. This is the campaign URL builder that Google provides. If you put your website in here, then you can put your campaign source, which is Google, campaign medium, which would be CPC for Google Ads, and then the name of your campaign in here. What it does is it constructs this URL for you. So you can see UTM source Google, UTM medium equals CPC, and UTM campaign equals campaign name. So how do you set this up within Google Ads to make sure that you're not having to do this manually every single time? So if you go into an ad and you click edit, you can see the final URL here. This is where you're actually sending the traffic. If you click on add URL options, you can see the tracking template. Now, one great dynamic feature Google provides is the LP URL variable. So first, we're going to start with curly brackets, LP URL, and then close brackets. And what this is going to do is insert the URL that you use up here into the tracking template. Now you put a question mark and UTM source equals Google and UTM medium equals CPC. Now, because these are always going to be in the URL, you can actually move these to another section. They're not going to be dynamic by ad. So if we put that into final URL suffix, it's always going to be appended. You'll see that later. The next thing we need to add is the UTM campaign. Now, we could set this manually and type in the name of the campaign, but a much better way to do this is to use value track parameters. So like LP URL, Google offers multiple value track parameters which insert dynamic information about the ad, the keywords, or the campaigns. In this case, we're going to use campaign ID. If we paste campaign ID, then the actual ID of the individual ad is going to get filled in. And this tracking template you can reuse across the account level, ad level, whatever it is, and you'll never have to change it because the campaign ID will always be dynamically inserted. You can also create your own custom parameters. So for example, if you have a dynamic ID you need to add, you can put that down here. Now, if you need to add that to the URL, you put an ampersand and then dynamic ID or whatever you need to call it. And then the only difference is you put an underscore first. So underscore dynamic ID. So now you have your tracking parameters built. Let's test them. We'll click test here. Great. So the landing page was found, very important to check, so you're not wasting your advertising budget. And we can also see that the parameters were all filled in dynamically. We can see UTM source equals Google, UTM medium equals CPC, UTM campaign equals the campaign ID, and that dynamic ID showed up too. If we click on this, we can go through to the landing page and just double check everything is okay. We can click into the URL and see that all of the values were filled in correctly. Once you've set up your tracking template, you shouldn't have to worry about your campaign tracking setup ever again.